hour has come. Amen.
Amen.
It is time to hear from our Father. Men, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Men, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Like Job said, I'm going to bring the person who is qualified to introduce the general. I am not qualified to do what? To introduce the general. So I'm going to invite the heaven qualified to do what? To introduce the general. So I invite our daddy, the parish pastor, Pastor Chidi Oyinbobi, to come and introduce the general.
Hallelujah! I want you to understand that it's not a mistake and it's not accidental. God planned it and it's intentional and it's for a purpose. Number one, God wants to uplift you.
Amen.
Number two, He wants to position you.
Amen.
Number three, He wants to place you specially. In the course tonight, there is divine customized blessing.
Hallelujah.
This one is made for you, so don't miss it. I read the book. A man was preaching in a crusade of about 6 million. And the man said, God told that in this 6 million, the message is only for one person. I was wondering, in 6 million people, only one person. He said, when you go to a gathering, focus. Maybe it's for you. This one now, we must listen. Because it's our daddy. He was one that brought us up, still bringing us up. He knows how to do it. The Bible said the son and father of him was the chastised. Some of us have been chastised and still back us back again. I don't know what they've done to you, but I want to tell you that for him out of his life schedule to steal this time to be here, to me, it means the most. Because of his position now, you hardly get it, you hardly. But that goes for the men. The men, God bless all of you, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
This meeting is not 2 months, not 3 months, not 4 months, not 5 months, not 6 months. Before you say, okay, I win. If you want to come in today, you must be strong. A lot of the temple fires. We want to thank God that God still made it. He's keeping out time to come. Please, it's all represented by our daddy, the provincial pastor, the conductor of services, pastor, and the pastor of the
that I have authority. But I'm ignorant of that authority. I don't know. I don't know who I am. Or I didn't know who I am. But tonight, God will open our eyes to know. Because we're going to be talking briefly, I'm not going to stay long here. Briefly, we are going to talk about the kingdom authority. And then we pray. I'm close. So can we just be on our feet? He touched my life with his hand. My life changed. He touched my life with his hand. My life changed. He touched my life with his hand. And my life is turned to you. Jehovah touched my life with his hand.
The first exhortation
said something, I do not need to go over them again. Thank God for his life, thank God for Brother Musa. Those of that share, they appreciate you. It's good at times for the father to sit down and listen to his children. And when you're coming up, you just give them fatherly blessing. And if I should do that tonight, it will not be a big deal. Amen.
Amen.
I'm glad. Well, we're just going to touch two things tonight in kingdom authority. I'm not going to define kingdom, that's not that done. I'm not going to define authority, that's been done. But just two things in the book of Genesis chapter 1. Genesis chapter 1. We're going to read 26 to 31. Genesis chapter 1, 26 to 21. And God said, let us make man in our own image, or in our image. After our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, created he him. Male and female, created he them. And God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in which is the fruit of a tree yielding seed, to you it shall be for meat. And to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth, wherein there is life, I have given every green herb for meat. And it was so. And God saw everything that he made, and behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We look at a world today that we that God gave us kingdom authority. And in the kingdom authority, I said we're going to discuss two things because of our time. We look at a few things there. The first thing God said, he said, and God said, let us make man. Let us make man. And God said, let us make man. In the making of man, the word there, God was saying, let us produce man. Let us prepare man. Let us do a work in man. So that they will look like us. In making man, was doing the work for a man to look exactly like him. not to be handsome, but to have the same authority. The same authority. That is, God said, let there be light. God in his own plan, while making man, was that man can also stand and say, let there be light. And it will be so. Because in making man, God was reproducing himself. Another word was God, that is, God was duplicating. Because God cannot come from heaven and do it. Of course, the Bible says that heaven cannot be condemning him. So he needed somebody on earth that will be like him. Let's take for an example. Do you know that Nigerian government has a government in Spain?
Yes.
Do you know that?
Yes.
And whatever decision the ambassador takes, it stands. Whatever document she signs, because she is representing a government. So, in the mind of God, what is the let us make man? Let us produce man in our image. The house was just opposite the church. time they will give you another position, another appointment. In David's time, they appointed him to be the chairman of the Electoral Commission.
Hallelujah.
That is what we are talking about, representing God, kingdom authority. You speak it. Now, the Bible says that the plan of God, that is the reason he said that the plan I have for you, is that the thought I have for you is of good. It's not of evil. So God wants you, God, when you appear and they are looking for God and they see you, they say, yeah, this is God. And that is the reason he said, for you to be made, to be fashioned in like him, you are to be appointed man to be appointed. And that is what we are talking about. Men, God created you to have that authority. God created you. When the Bible is talking about the creation, there are differences between created and made. The world was created, everything was created by the word of God. But when it came to man, they took time to make. That is the reason the Bible said, and God said, let us make. God did not say, let us create. I want you to look at the two worlds. He said, let us make. So they came together. They put their ideas together. And then decided, they said, man is going to be like, and finally, they said, let that man be like us. So that, once, that is the reason the Bible said, whatever thing you say that it should come, that thing will come. Because whatever you bind here on earth, it will stand. And it is only man or a man who knows his authority that can do that. I said I'm not going to waste time because of we don't have much. Now, and the Bible said, let them that the first authority, that means the kingdom authority I want to share tonight. He said, let them have dominion. Or what I was saying, the first kingdom authority is let them have dominion. What is dominion? Dominion means to have control. Just have control. So when you have control, another word is that for you to rule. So you have control to able to rule. You have control. You have control. Come. What? You are created to have control. You are not created to lose control. Nothing should make you to lose control. Once a man loses control, that is the reason, man, you cannot operate with anger. Because anger will make you to lose control. You know what you are, you will not obey him now. Be in charge, that is dominion. Be in charge. Now when they are talking about being in charge, they are talking about another one. You be in charge of your life. You are in charge. Nothing moves you here and there. You are in charge. Because God is in charge of himself. Number two, The number three thing, you are in charge of the circumstances. Nothing should push you here. You are in charge. You are in charge. And anywhere you go, you must be able to stand that you are in charge. And no man intimidates you. I've had a few meetings, maybe a few years ago. I think one was this year. Yeah. This one of the meetings I had, I was invited somewhere. I don't know whether I shared this here. And it used to be meetings of some ambassadors. So they were introducing me and introducing themselves. And I got to Tunisia, ambassador, and introduced himself. And then he asked me, from which country? You are ambassador of which country? And I told him, I'm the ambassador of the kingdom of heaven. And he said, you have never had this one before. Where is that kingdom? I said, the kingdom of heaven. He said, are you not coming from any country? I said, I am the ambassador in charge of all of you. And he looked at me, and of course, I am in charge of all of them. And if I say you are going to be removed today, you will be removed. If you don't believe me, go and ask the ambassador of Kenya. He came to me and he said, they've called me. And that was 2000, when that Joe was to come. That was 2 years ago. To Valencia. They called me, I said, you are not going. Because I want you to be in that meeting. He said, Pastor, how can it be? I said, Your Excellency, you are not going. You are going to finish that meeting until I say you go. He turned and looked at me. He said, okay, if at that time I don't go, I'll be there. I said, don't tell me at that time. Go and prepare and come for the meeting. He went. There were about 5 ambassadors that came to receive that job. After that, he ran to me. He said, Pastor, I don't want to go. Pray again. I said, don't tell me pray again. The one I prayed, have you come to appreciate me? Come and show sin first. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And he said, no, I don't want to go. I'm not joking. I said, Your Excellency, you will not go. When do you want to go? If I want to stay 1 year again, I said, you are staying 1 year again. That is all. And stay. We met again this year. Since 2 years ago, you suppose I've gone February 2015 or 16. We met again this year. He said, I'm giving you an invitation. I said, why? He said, all the ambassadors, African ambassadors in Chennai, I want you to address us.
Glory.
I said, where? He said, I will. And he sent the invitation. And I went. That was the first place, the first time the Nigerian ambassador saw me. Because they were introducing me.
Oh, yeah.
And from this, you are welcome, from this, every one of them. It was then the Nigerian ambassador said he wants to have a meeting with me. I don't run after anybody because I know my authority. Until last week Thursday, choose the Lord. Because the other week my phone rang. I said, yes, who is this? He said, is that Pastor Rogers? I said, yes. He said, please, the ambassador had been waiting for you. She wants to have a meeting with you. And I went, and she said, I know you have influence in this country. I know if you say this, it will be so. Please, things that are happening in Nigeria, why don't you? I said, I'm not in politics. We talked, we had a meeting. Why am I sharing this? It's knowing your authority. That you are in charge. Man, you are in charge because you have the. He said, for you to have dominion. Is let us make man in our own image. Let the man look like us. When we look at the man physically, he looks like you. When you look at him spiritually, he has authority like God. He will say this, and that's all. Man like Abraham, who never gave up, he recognized his authority. Abraham's nephew was taken away, Lord. And Abraham said, it cannot happen. Man, you need to start to say, it cannot happen. That is kingdom authority that I've been giving to you to be in charge. It cannot happen. It cannot. The Bible said that Abraham was shoot. That is the Bible in the book of Genesis, I think Genesis chapter 14. Verse 20 or so. Abraham pursued and then captured and he got everything that does make no wonder God himself met him. The Bible said that when he was returning back, he met a man called Melchizedek. And Melchizedek blessed him. Melchizedek means King of Peace. The Bible says that he never had a beginning. And he never had an ending. Who is he? God. Because it is only God that does not have beginning and ending. So God decided to make his best and go. This man that acted in my place, this man that recognizes his authority, I need to show myself. And that was the reason God showed up. And blessed him. When you know your authority, God blesses you. Amen. When you know your stand, God is happy. Come on, man, I'm talking to you. When you see your children, your child, or your children standing in your authority, you will be happy. So God showed up, and God blessed him. And Abraham said, no, this one has blessed me. Take one tenth of all that I have recovered. That is the first time that was mentioned in the Bible. And Abraham gave God that. Thank you for the information. People like Elisha or Elijah. And Elisha. Elijah who refused a man, a king, to intimidate him. The king had been terrorized in the nation. The king had been wild. And Elijah said, come on, is it not this God that I'm serving? Abraham has said, he said, you have been the man. When that God has said, you man of God, and Elijah said, me, man of God. Okay. got provoked. If I be a man of God, if I am standing in the place of God, fire! Come down. Control them. Nature obey. Once nature recognizes your authority, obey. Once the forces of darkness recognizes your authority, bow. What we are talking tonight is authority, power. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That is the reason you are being made. That is the reason you are being made. You were not created like an animal. You were not created like a star. You were not created like a jellyfish. But you were made to be like your father. There was a man, or still a pastor, in the Redeeming Ghost place, Pastor Deloitte. I don't know how many of you know Ayo Deloitte in those days. When Ayo speaks, in those days, you will think that it was like a Jew. Ayo, because he had been, come on, they said that when the show had been with the leaf, even the leaf turned to the show. So Ayo had been so close. So he was speaking like that Jew. He was walking like that because he's as tall as that Jew. So you can easily mistake him. So what we are talking tonight is not just a resemblance, but the Bible is a complete resemblance. Not that he just resembling in talking, no, but in everything, complete resemblance. So that is the first kingdom authority. Hard world of dominion. Big charge, big control. Rule. Rule. Take over. That is what he's talking about. The first kingdom authority. Big charge. Am I talking to somebody tonight?
Verse 26.
Yeah. Now verse 27, verse 28. Verse 28, let's just read it together. One, two, go. And God blessed them. And God said, come on. Can we read it together? Are we, George?
Yes.
Are we together?
Yes.
Okay, let's go to verse 28. One, two, go. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful. He said, and God blessed them. See. He said, and God blessed them. And God blessed them. Now look at that. That's the and God said, God bless them. God bless them. Now, and God said, number one thing he said, be fruitful. Be fruitful. And the word fruitful means what? Produce. Have branches. I like that. Have branches. Don't be alone. Be fruitful. Have branches. Branch off. That was what made us. In Spain, Brother Daniel was sharing something. You know, here in Spain, only few people can tell the story of the redeemed privilege of God. Yesterday, I had some calls, and I was reflecting, I was saying something, you know, and I discovered that the redeemed Christian Church of God, before we had our crisis, was the only, and still the okay, let me say, was the only mission in Europe that within 10 years of its existence that has over 50 churches. What happened? Because God instructed us to branch off. He said, multiply. And in those days in Malaga, we all know, I used to tell them that you don't need to take permission from God. It is God that has sent me, call you, pray for you, go to such a place, go and start a parish. That's all. Here, from Malaga here, we pay our pastors. Daniel can testify. Because he was the person who used to come and disturb me. He said, we will write a petition against you. You use all our money to plant churches. Our land. You pay them. Pay the church rent. We pay the pastor's house, pay their church rent, pay the pastor. Even though we want to give them, it was not bad. We pay that. Consider paying a house. Maybe about 500 euros, 550. At least. Then pay the church rent. Not less than 500. That is 1,000. Maybe we give some 300 or 400 or 500. Depends. So each pastor. And at times, we could support up to 7. In a month. Because God gave us that command. He said, multiply. Right? He said,
be fruitful.
So we were fruitful. And it came to time Because we were fruitful, that was a time when all the workers gathered. The attendants, they gave me, we were over 500 people, workers alone. We shall get there again.
Amen.
I said, we shall get there again.
Amen.
And that is the purpose of this conference. For us to come back again. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So I said, be fruitful. Fruitful, I said, it means, you know, branch off. And another word here is multiply. Not only that you should be fruitful, it's that multiply. Multiply means not just 1 plus 1. When they say multiply that, they are talking about times. If you are 2, add 2. So multiply. I don't want to do too much revelation effects. So when we look at that word, when they say a man should bear fruit, you bear fruit in 3 ways. Number 1, fruit of your body. So they are talking about give birth, have children. So man was given that authority to do what? To have children. Number 2, be fruitful means be financially buoyant. That is the reason he said in the book of God, John 1:2, he said, above all things that you should do what?
Prosper.
To prosper means what? It means to be successful. It means to succeed in business or in business affair. So, in this meeting, we might not pray tonight, but if I wish you have time, we are going to have a business section where we pray for business people. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Those in business, those that are working. Because if you have 10 people doing business in this church, 10 people doing business in this church, the church will not suffer. Why are we crying that people are relocating? Let them relocate. And let God relocate other people here. Let them go. Brother Nostar was sharing a testimony when he was driving here. Even in Spain, he could get a job and be promoted. He's not doing a nonsense job. He's doing a clean job. What I mean, a clean job, is not doing fraud. He's doing a legitimate, and they promoted him. Let's say, let's have 5 of them like that. The church will prosper. So pastors, we should stop looking back and we look forward. We should be able to take charge and pray. Nothing should make you to lose control. One thing that has helped me recently is for I don't look at the number of people I have. I will not take shame and eat shit. I will do what I can do with the authority God has given me. If maybe in my church today, I don't know, maybe this one is bigger than my church. But it does not move me. What moves me is I am in a place. I had a big place. Some of you know the place. The altar was fantastic. I know how much we put into that place. It was a befitting headquarter. Each time I climbed into that pulpit, I felt and said, wow. But I want to tell you something. God does not work with your plan. Whatever He wants to do, He will do it. But suddenly, that thing disappeared. And I mourned that place for years. I was so angry. Why would that thing, they would have helped me, they would have done that, why there's no money? But it kept taking time. I said, come on, Rogers, will you stop complaining? And I started talking to my soul. I said, stop complaining, oh my soul. Stop complaining, oh my soul. Stop complaining. Because I must move forward. So don't look at that people have relocated. Oh, we are just 10. What will that 10? God will raise another 10.
Amen.
Amen. Instrument. God, teach. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So don't sit down and lament over your problems, over your failure, over yesterday. So the Bible says, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper.
Ajebule knows Lagos.
The thought of going to Ajegunle alone killed me. Ajegunle. I called my pastor friend so that he take me to Ajegunle. He said, "Pastor, I can't drive to Ajegunle. We have to take public transport." I was surprised that pastor was acting with change. 50 naira. I said, "What are you arguing? Maybe I can come on to go with him." I don't know that shit. He said, "Pastor, 50 naira is more new." Oh my God. 50 naira. Money. I told the conductor, "How much?" He said, "Two of you is 200. Pastor said, "No, it's 150. I put that, I said, I gave him 500. I said, "You have 200? He said, "Yes, I gave you 200. Take care of it." Pastor said, no. I said, "Pastor, it's not your money. I paid. Let the man alone. Let the man go." And the conductor said, "Hey, God bless you, sir. God bless you." I said, "Go. When you don't have, my prayer is that after this conference, somebody will give a testimony." Thank you, Lord Jesus. The last thing I'm going to share, be fruitful spiritually. Some of us are not spiritually fruitful. You can be fruitful having babies. So you can be fruitful in the body. You can be fruitful financially. But if you are not spiritually fruitful, you have a big problem. Now, the Bible says in the book of Galatians chapter 5 verse 22, we have what they call the fruit of the Spirit. It is that fruit of the Spirit that controls a man. A man can be so wealthy, but he does not have character, all equals to zero. A man can have as many children as he wants, but if you are not spiritually fruitful, you will amount to nothing. I want you to desire. I want you to convert the greatest gift, and that is spiritual gift. To bring that to a close, the second authority is to subdue. Is to subdue. Because after blessing them, and he said, "Do this and do that," he said, "And subdue." And subdue. To subdue means to bring under control again. Subdue the act. Subdue the circumstances. Subdue. Bring them under your feet. When you're walking, let it be that thing is under your feet. Man, I used to say that man does not cry. In America here, when I was here, some men used to come to my office and say, "Hey, Pastor, I'm so depressed." They shut up. African men, we are not depressed. Where do you learn that one? Is it because you are in Europe? You are telling them, "Come on, you are not depressed." I didn't look at them with pity. I said, "Come on, shut up. You don't say you are depressed." So do. Bring them under control. Bring them under your feet. Whatever it is, bring them under your feet. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Hi.
once in a while. And when you see rabbits, the heaven is open. The volleyball floor harvest. You have been bought out. So just what you have. Talk to God. Appreciate God for this vessel. For what he has done through him this day. God has been spoken to you and I. It's a time of favor. Anointing has been gone. Let God fill him. So the seed of prayer is there. Ministry. Family. It's the man that lies there all the time. Let God have my voice concerning his movement. Heavens will